So those go in. Needle, crypt, shackles, EEs, and all the crappy white cards go out. I'm still back and forth on the one Vidalkin shackles, but I think I'd rather see what he boards first. If he boards in Vendilions and Glenelg Archmages, for example, you do want the shackles, but not all of them do that, and until then, I'd rather have the five combo pieces and the three Chromoxes artifacts, and I'd rather... The other card I might take out was Tezzeret, but... No, I cannot mulligan that hand. Didn't have a turn three Cranial, but... you know, still can't mulligan it. So he's either got two different 2-drops to play, or, you know, has Mana Leak or something, which I'm fine with. Mystic Gate helps cast Kitchen Finks pretty well. Peer Through Depths. I think I allow that. Plus, he might miss. Hitting another Peer is fine. I think Mana Leak and Search for Tomorrow is actually good. Mana Leak gets pretty dead pretty fast in this matchup. And it can slow down his kill also. If he wants to remand my Mana Leak, I'm also more than fine with that. Ponder, land, remand my Finks is probably what's going to end up happening here. Like Mystic Gate. Originally had one, but when you have Finks on the board, you definitely want the second, and Pulse of the Fields, too. This guy, he might watch my replays. He doesn't want to get Cranialed on turn three. And the reason not to tap out here is not too much he can play that's altogether relevant the next turn. And if he remands it, that's fine, too. Or condescends it, or peers in response. Alright, so he's got Escape Shift. That we know. Ooh, he doesn't have lands. Now this Sphinx is going to do its job then, I think. I think it's going to be pretty good this game. Especially since I have Mana Leak and whatnot. Magma Jet me, sure. I don't think wasting a counter on that is very good. I mean, yeah, I could draw him two cards if his top two cards are dead cards, but I think I'd rather Mana Leak a Scourge Tribe Elder or something. And he goes top, so it didn't actually do anything. Definitely don't want to thirst here. Get Cryptic Commanded. And we will pay the life. If he goes to Cryptic, bounce my Sphinx, I think I'm okay with that too. Yeah, you can just keep peering. I mean, there's a time and a place to counter peers, and I think when he's stuck on mana, my Mana Leaks and Negates are going to be good. Good thing I Mana Leaked that Search for Tomorrow. That was pretty good. Sure, you can continue to Magma Jet me. See, he's ready for my Meddling Mages. It's another reason I don't like Meddling Mage. Would have just been bad this game. Spend search. It means my thirst is definitely resolving. I will be Mana Leaking Remand here. If he chooses to use it. Nope, maybe not. That looks like he is going to use Remand. which I will mana leak. Mana leak's getting to the point where it's not going to be great, so, and I want to draw some action, or some Chromoxes. That's a lot of Chromoxes. He's pretty low life, though. It's just been dealing him now, I suppose. Scapeshifter man, yeah. I'll take his cryptic. He can't do anything too threatening next turn. So this actually threatens lethal. And play the Mox to the cryptic. Would be able to stop me from lethal if, you know, he had it still. Finks are not exactly what you think of as a sideboard card against combo, but, you know, they actually attack them, put them on a clock. Which I think is fine. Better than, like, a, you know, Path to Exile or Wrath of God. Missing land drops hurts pretty badly in Scapeshift, considering they need 7 in play to kill you. So that Scapeshift is just a complete dead card right now. You could have Magma Jetted this Vendilion. I think you would have been in better shape if you just Magma Jet my Finks twice. I mean, there wasn't really a reason not to. It's a Career Tribuilder. Oh, well, I guess I'm not killing him this turn. So he's got a turn before he dies. But there's no real... Don't really think he has outs here. Especially since I can negate his Scapeshift. Actually, I am an artifact short of surviving, so if he draws Scapeshift and a hard counter, but I don't think he has any hard counters that can stop negate on Scapeshift. Even if he does, you know, Scourge Tribuilder and search for land, then Scapeshift me. So I suppose we'll see. I mean, who knows, maybe he'll search, play a land, Scapeshift, and like guttural response, my negate. Can't say I would expect that. Might not have even drawn the land. In which case, he doesn't know I have this counter in my hand, so he's got to go for it, but unfortunately it's not going to work. Alright, he chose to not shuffle, which means, presume he found the land and is going for it. I have to admit, it would be kind of surprising if he had like a muddle or something or a negate of his own. And that would be pretty good, since it would actually do it here. But no, he does not have that. I don't think. Oh, no, okay. He's leaving 2 blue in his pool. Going down to 1 blue, 1 green. Alright, and that'll do it. Sweet, 3 now.